Hello, welcome by a new video on Julia. Today we will talk about vectors and arrays and matrices. A vector we make this way with square brackets, 1, 2 for instance, and then you get a column vector. If you do a space in between, 1, 2, we get a row vector, but we can make a column vector from it if we use the reshape function w2, and now it makes a column vector from it. We can also make let's first consider dot product, so that is 1 × 1, so the dot product of so if you make a more interesting example 3, 4, and then the dot product of phi and w is 1 × 3 and 2 + 2 × 4, and you can do that with dot phi w, and then you have to use the linear algebra package, and if we do that again, then you get the right answer. We can also make matrices in the following way. So 1, 2, for instance, 3, 4. So this is the first row. This is second row. And or you write M is 1, 2, and then dots, comma 3, 4, and you get the same matrix. If you do M times P, that is the product of the matrix M times the vector phi, or you can search for solution, so M/V, and if we store this as X, then it looks for a vector x, so that m times x is equal to phi. So if you do m times x, it's phi. That's true. There is a difference between this and, for instance, dot is. Then it does the pointwise comparison, so it compares its vector element of m times x with its vector element of v. We also have ranges in Julia, for instance 1 to 10, that represents the numbers 1 to up to 10, and or for instance, with step 2, 1 to 10, is 1, 2, up to at most 10. So if we do collect x, we get all the numbers. You can also initiate an empty array with x, this string, square brackets, square brackets open, square brackets closed, and these are zero elements of type string. We can add elements to X with the push function, for instance, Julia push X programming. And if you do join X with a space in between, you get Julia programming. We can initiate an array of floats and of size 2 × 2. With undefined values. That's, for instance, useful when when you know beforehand the size of the function, and you can pre-allocate memory so that your function is faster. So you get arbitrary numbers. We can take the matrix transpose with the accent, and accent is the adjoint. So if these are complex numbers, it takes the complex conjugates, and then transpose. That you can calculate the determinant of M, the rank of M, the trace of M, the inverse of M. Now, for instance, if we can calculate the eigenvalues of M, eigenvex M, and it must be eigenvectors M and eigenvalues of M, eigenvalue M. And if we do a lambda, it's eigenvalues M1, then we get this number, so the first number. And if we want the first eigenvector of M, so that is the first column, we do eigenvectors M. We want all the rows, so we do that with double points, and then the first column, and check it is good. And if we store that as the vector x, and we calculate x times n is this, and if we calculate lambda times x, we get the same answer. We can calculate the factorization with the factorized function. So this is the LU decomposition of the matrix M, and if we do F dot L, we get the L vector, and F dot U, we get the U vector, and if we do F times L times F times U, then we get the original matrix back. M times M gives the matrix multiplication of M care M. And M dot times M does dot-wise, point-wise multiplication, so 1k1, 2k2, 3k3, and 4k4, so that's different. Then there is an interesting or useful function, diagonal M, and then you can make a diagonal matrix. For instance, if you want the vector 1, 2, 3 on the first diagonal, so that you is 1 above the 0th diagonal, you get this matrix. And if you want it on position minus 1, you get it here. Or if you just want the diagonal matrix with 1, 2, 3, get this matrix. Then there's the uniform scaling object. So uniform scaling 2, for instance, that represents an identity matrix times, two times the identity matrix, and if we do M plus US, and if we do back, but MS, so it does, it adds 2 to the diagonal. So 1 plus 2 and 4 plus 2, and the other entries stay the same. We can make a symmetric matrix. So it makes, so if we compare that with M, it takes the upper triangle and makes a normal symmetric matrix from it. And for a symmetric matrix, you need roughly a half of the entries to remember. And so it can, Julia can store symmetric matrix more efficiently. So there is a special symmetric array type. Then there is also a diagonal object, or a diagonal and then a vector. Yeah, that was it. It's useful to read the documentation on internet, and you can always, if you want to know something, if you want to know something about the diagonal, then you get, in this case, a whole lot of information about how to construct and with examples. It's very useful. Then I have some exercises. The first exercise is, find a function to calculate the exponent of a matrix, which is defined like this. So it is the sum from 0 to infinity of 1 over k faculty times the matrix to the power k. The second exercise is, suppose M is again this matrix, and use Julia to calculate the point-wise exponent, so two to the, e to the power 2, e to the power 3, e to the power 5, and e to the power 9. And what's the difference with the previous exercise? And then so exercise 3, read the documentations on ranges. How can you make an object that represents a decreasing number of numbers, similar to 1 to 10? So instead of 1 to up to 10, for instance, 10, 9, up to 1. How can you make such an object? Okay, good luck with this. See you next time. Bye.